Fed, it's from Market Watch. Here's the headline: Bitcoin is close to becoming worthless. The article was written by Ayatollah Sarin, finance professor at Santa Clara University, who joins us now. Sir, make your case, please.
Thanks, Stuart. Stuart, there is actually a fundamental reason for that and a technical reason for it. Fundamentally, Bitcoin has not lived up to its hype. Primarily, if you look at all the activity around Bitcoin, it's mostly around trading. It doesn't seem to have too many use cases.
Okay.
The ultimate promise of helping it bank the unbanked has certainly, it has not lived up to it. But from a technical perspective, and that's what I'm talking about in this article about the death spiral, to understand that we have to go back last year when the price was around 19,000 or so. At that point in time, the future trading started. And what you could do essentially was you could mine Bitcoin at around 5,000 while you could sell it in the futures market around 19,000. And that clearly attracted a lot of arbitragers who got involved with the mining activities and were guaranteed an arbitrage profit. As more and more entered into the market, what happened was that the price of Bitcoin declined and it came around where it should have been, which is sort of the cost of mining plus a modest profit. But now the prices are falling. And actually, all the miners are in a position whereby they land up making negative profits.
So it costs more to mine this
consequently,
thing. I'm not quite sure what is meant by this, but it costs more.
So once again, this is some good FUD and probably scaring people. And they are mentioning the cost of Bitcoin, and they set it up at 5,000. But if you do have some background and you understand how cryptocurrencies work, mining costs are not fixed. And I would probably have to make another video, and I highly recommend if you go through my channel, there are some other videos I have, and even in YouTube, where the mining costs will come down. If there's less and less people mining, it actually costs less. It requires less electricity. It unfortunately becomes less secure, but at the same time, the mining prices will come down. And what a lot of miners can do is shut down a part of their mining operation and just wait for the price to stabilize. So a lot of these miners at these low prices, I mean, it's going to possibly stay for a little while, but a lot of them can go and reduce their cost. And the ones that continue to mine, they're not going to have to spend the same amount of money to be able to mine the Bitcoins to continue going. And at the same time, as people keep exiting, it does allow large institutions, big hedge funds, to basically buy this asset on the cheap. And I don't know when that's going to happen, but eventually it's going to look attractive enough where, you know, certain people are not going to want to just be sitting on fiat, and they will take advantage of this. But I will be playing more of this interview and kind of going over what questions he brings up and kind of giving my opinion and analysis. And let me know your thoughts on this as well, and I will talk to you soon.